We are going to cover Richie Jackson's Death Skateboards part. It is the most viewed skateboard video on YouTube. It's super creative. And every single trick in this part is kind of mind-blowing.
Absolutely. So is it the, you're not saying it's the most viewed YouTube skate video, you're saying it's the most viewed part. So like somebody's specific video part where they put out a video part, usually in a skate video you'll have, you know, like 5 to 10, 12 different parts if there's a ton of guys or something like that. So this is his part, the most viewed on YouTube. And why do you think it's the most viewed on YouTube?
Because it's the most creative.
Got it.
There is like, he is the, man, how do you describe it? He, the creativity that exudes out of his skateboarding is unlike anything we've seen in the typical format of modern day skateboarding.
Let's watch.
Have you seen this part?
Yeah.
How long ago? Keep going, it's fine.
Yeah, a while ago.
I haven't seen this for probably a couple years. You know, he says he doesn't use wax.
I don't think you want wax on the on your grip tape, dude.
How do you not use wax for that?
Because you're sliding down the stairs. You don't need wax for a firecracker.
I actually really like the power slide trick after. I kind of feel, you've seen me do that. I would like that.
On accident or on purpose?
On purpose. Okay. It's like a quick power slide revert to pop trick.
You gotta always protect your hand, you know? You don't need gloves, just use a little sign.
Dude, how do you even think about that?
Billy, you're ruining it. He really likes those signs.
It's like a section in your part, you know?
The sign section?
Yeah, where you do like 3 wall rides and then you call it the wall ride part.
How many kids do you think watch this and are then like, dude, this is like the best tricks because I've never seen them before and I need to learn these tricks? And how many kids go off and learn these?
Well, these aren't like, hey, I gotta go learn how to trade flip. This is like one and done. There's not, like, that could be something you learn, like power slide and a tail slide, which is really cool.
So you're saying he does it, so.
That's gnarly. Okay. How long do you think it takes him to do these?
Days.
You know what's funny is I bet his filmer just.
It's most like, patient guy in the world.
Yeah, it's like, this is like worse than a manual trick. Like, hey, you wanna go film a manual trick? The filmer's like, no. But like, Richie Jackson goes out and he's like, hey, you ready? I'm gonna.
People say they don't wanna film a manual trick because a manual trick takes forever. And I think also, even if you land a manual trick, it doesn't matter how sick it is. Like, it's like.
It took forever.
Well, it's not that great of a trick in your part, no matter how good the manual trick is. So I think that's why.
What? Manual tricks are.
I mean, it depends. I mean, for most skaters, because most skaters aren't day one. Do you know what I mean? So their manual trick, even if they pull it off, it's just not worth filming. And it takes forever. So I think that's.
But what is. Like, how do you think of that?
You just get really bored?
I don't know. Is it bored? Or is there like something just different going on in his brain? I've heard interviews with him. He thinks different.
I mean, this is a little ridiculous. That's hilarious, and I love that.
He said there's no wax on there.
I don't think you super need wax when you're like going downstairs.
Have you ever done that?
Yes.
Like at your house?
Yeah.
Just like play around with the board?
No.
What?
I've done this though.
No, but when you're at your house, lay on your back, play with the board on your feet.
No, because I like my face.
It's hard. Yeah, it's definitely hard.
I don't like my board falling on my face.
Remember all the stair skating we used to do?
Oh, wait.
Stairboarding?
You guys did that a lot more.
Was that the Ender?
Yeah, he went down the thing.
Now Mike Mastastroni. Is that the filmer or editor?
Oh, man, that was last
I don't know, maybe you should be looking at the screen.
Yeah, filmer. props to you, man. I know you wish that I could be. You must be a very patient human being. More
than any other behind the scenes. You've ever known.
Oh, that's cool. The way I should you do look that. At me, sometimes wow, that makes me feel looked clean in regular what's time.
So who's this second filmer that's just creeping in the background, or is it just the camera on a tripod? What do you think?
Again, this goes back to how long it takes them to do these tricks. It's probably a tripod.
That's actually a good idea. You know, have just a second camera rolling on a tripod far away.
I mean, we do that.
Sometimes. I think most of the time we don't.
I went and skated by myself this weekend, and it was just on a tripod.
I'm sure the footage turned out great.
Yeah, it did. In Premiere, I just make it look like it's moving with me.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'm sure that looks really natural.
Super natural. I mean, when you think about it, nobody notices because people are just focused.
Because nobody's watching your part?
Nobody. Yes. But also, nobody's paying attention to how it's edited, per se, for the most part.
Because they're not watching it?
Yeah. I have 100 followers on this.
I know where that spot is, but I will never tell.
Seriously? It's a manual pad.
No, I know, but nobody knows where it is. And I do.
And it's a manual pad where you have to go a 180 instead of like straight.
Yeah, or you just skate it off as a little curb drop like I would.
Yeah, of course.
Oh my god, dude.
What do they call that?
RJ.
Foot slide.
Ooh, that is actually pretty hard.
I don't even know if I like that. I don't know. So I don't even know.
Well, his credit section is about as long as his part. Oh, who's that fella?
So I just don't know if I don't know why that doesn't just like hit home for me.
What, you didn't like it?
I liked it. It's just, it's so different that I don't even know how to appreciate it. Like, it took, every single one of those tricks probably took way longer than a manual trick that's just right outside of your comfort zone.
Yeah.
It's next level, but it's also kind of confusing for a regular skateboarder.
I think the hardest part about it is just coming up with all the different things that you want to do, because a lot of people kind of just think in the terms of like, well, here's like a set bag of tricks. I'm going to learn this, get it really good, and try to do it down something bigger. And you could spend your entire life just trying to do that.
Yeah.
And just trying to master the basics.
Yeah.
And, you know, some people that are really good and skate big things, they joke that they only have 10 tricks. You know what I mean? They have the same like 10 tricks or whatever.
Yeah.
And this just requires you to think a little differently and look at a spot. Like people say that, you know, skaters, when they see something and we see it differently because it's a skate spot to us, it's not just like a handrail or a stair set or a ditch or whatever. Mm-hmm. We have skate radar, like we can see spots. Well, I think he just probably looks at spots a little bit different and is like, I could do this or this or this or something that I've done in the past. I could just put a little tweak on it and make it different.
After seeing his part, though, he's kind of like a big gap, big rail skater in the sense that he only has a few tricks. He's got like some crazy random manual.
Okay. You mean the two-wheel manual?
Yeah, he's got the two-wheel manual.
That thing's nuts.
He's got his foot slide.
Yeah.
He's got the using a utensil. Sign.
You mean like a sign?
Yeah, like a sign.
Power sliding on the sign.
Power slide to trick. So
yeah.
So yeah, he's not, as much as we could say he's just completely different in a lot of ways, he just has his own style.
Well, I think there's so many different things that you can do on a skateboard, and I feel like he's gotten a lot of them. as far as things that you don't see often.
He didn't kickflip a six stair.
Why would you kickflip a six stair?
Well, like, I mean, it just because I didn't see him kickflip anything over a tube.
He didn't do any of the typical standard normal tricks that you would expect to see.
Like, yeah, I guess for me, it's like I would appreciate seeing him do a tray flip down a six into a line where then he does a dark slide.
Mm. Or I don't think he has time for that.
Yeah, maybe. I do. I've listened to his interviews, and I really appreciate the way he thinks. It's very abstract. It's very 3,000 foot view. yeah, the guy is a genius in a way that we will never understand.
All right, I think it's time for another video.